What's up, fam? So, building shelves for storage and tools, etc., for a business. So, I'm just trying to find a place to put you. Recruited some help. I'm normally doing this all by myself, so. Boom, 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 boom. $25 an hour if you know anybody who knows their stuff.
Let you play along for a minute.
Ooh. Ooh. Oh, man. Harder than I thought it would be. Boom. Yeah. So I got Pam drilling pilot holes. We just cut all these boards down here. Right now I'm rigging them to conserve wood, and the general purpose will be strong. So I'm ripping, this is all dried ash that I purchased from a private seller. So I'm just ripping them in half, and then we're drilling pilot holes in these. And then we already measured our boards. Hey, before you screw these in, though, measure the total length of these and make sure that they're long. Because this is an old set for those sets, and they may not be. 81. Yeah. So we'll set these two aside and. Use fresh.
Alright,
so back to ripping. I have no power out here, so I'm using all battery operated tools, no table saw. So I'm ripping these right next to my hand. It's not advisable for someone who does not have as much experience as me. I just want to show you guys the difference between ash and pine, right? So I am going to use some pine for this, but, you know, it's going to serve a good, it's going to serve well for its purpose, right? So here's your pine from this angle, and here's your ash, right? So, as you can see, the ash is an extremely dense hardwood, and the pine is an it's a soft, you know, white wood, right? That is definitely not as strong as, you know, your hardwoods, right? But the ash I really like because it's so dense. And very strong. And if you use a sweat box with it, you can shape the wood pretty easily. And that's you know, I really don't like ash for that. But, you know, for anything, really, like for shelf building and stuff, your ash is definitely the wood to go to. You can get it a lot cheaper than, like, oaks and maples and stuff like that. And it's just as strong, if not stronger. Sorry, guys. It's cold out here. When I'm explaining stuff, I feel like I sound like an idiot. So... So, just exhausted another battery, but I'm still going to use this for my runner boards that support the top of the shelves. But in regards to, well, you know, it's depending on if it's weak or not, right? So this is a weak spot, right? So you got this knot right here that comes down here. What you want to look for is if it's all the way through, and it is, right? So, but this board, I think, is going to be definitely strong enough just to hold some miscellaneous stuff, but it might not be. Yeah, it's good. Totally solid. So if you look here too, it's not split all the way through, right? It's pretty good. But I have some other examples I can show you too. But for right now, I'm going to cut you off, and we're going to get the building, and then I'll turn you back on when we're at another stage.